we are getting married in the Draper Temple on August 16th, 2017.
Well, it's a funny story because we met 2 years previous to that.
And my best friend Kelly and I, we went dancing in Provo, country dancing. He asked me to dance, and I just remember him being super funny and a really good dancer.
And we like to say that we both weren't ready at the time.
I think he was too chicken to ask for my number.
I know I wasn't ready. I was still a boy trying to play man. And she, I guess, had a few life lessons as well.
Obviously, it wasn't the right time for us to go on dates or anything, and I never saw him again. And then 2 years later, almost exactly 2 years later, my best friend and I went country dancing again.
I went dancing the week after my birthday, and I was sitting at the front counter, and she came walking up, and she was stunning. I could see her when she first walked in, and
and it was funny how it worked out because I went up to go buy my friend and I some water.
Grabbed her hand, I pushed it down, and I go, "Pretty girls don't buy water."
And I was like, I just hit him. I was like, "Oh, well, thank you. That's very nice of you."
And I just look at her and I just watch her leave and go out on the floor. And I think I was in the middle of a conversation, but I just forgot everything that was going on, and I walked out and asked her to dance. It was awesome. We just had a real connection and I loved it. And right after that dance, I grabbed my friend Chris and I said, as she's leaving, she's going outside, and I said, "Guys, that's my future wife." And Chris, being the friend that he is, ran out to bang on the window.
Chris taps on the window and he's like, "Hey, come inside." Chris goes, "Oh, well, I just thought I'd meet you because you guys are gonna get married.
If you're gonna marry my best friend, I have to get to know you a little." When's the wedding? And she's like, "Oh, really? Don't you think we should go on a date first?"
I thought it was so funny, and I was like, "Oh, whatever, you're joking. Like, good one, you know." But we kept talking, and the two of them asked Kelly and I on a date.
And so she took my number down, and I remember the rest of the night just sitting and watching her. That girl is stunning. So I told my friend, I said, "Hey, put this song on. Like, shut it down, put this song on so I can go ask her to dance." So they did. They stopped the music and everything. Just like, "What's going on?" And I ran out and grabbed her. And I was like, "Hey, I'm doing this for you."
He basically just like worked his way through all these guys and asked, he's like, "Hey, can I have this dance?" And I was like, "Well, of course." And 2 weeks later, we went horseback riding and had a good time. And then I think from the first date on, I was pretty much sold. I'm like, "This guy's awesome. I like him."
To have my own family. That's what I aspire for. To come home and not genuinely worry if I'm loved, because I can see it in her eyes every time I see her that I am. And to grow up together and learn and to know that she's gonna have trouble and struggles and I get to be there to help her. For as much as I'm excited about like going on our honeymoon or buying our first house or having our first kid, it's more about our first fight, our first struggles. Because I feel like you learn a lot from people who struggle. And coming from somebody who's had a few struggles, I feel like it's made me stronger to better prepare us for struggles, and I'm excited to help her with that. As much as she inspires me in the gospel, I'm ready to help her through struggles.
He is one of the kindest human beings I've ever met. He will drop everything just to help not only me but everyone around him. I love how much of a gentleman he is. He'll never let me open my car door. He'll never let me open any door. I love how much of a hard worker he is. And I love how strong he is in the gospel. It's an honest truth and a good fact about him. He's just very strong and has his own real testimony about the church. And I love that about him.
I love you. And I make mistakes. I'm a little crazy. I have special faults. But if you can get past that, like, you've already done, and you know that, I have amazing blessings to give. And one thing that you need to know is I'm very loyal. And there's nothing that will come between us where I will stop loving you, where I won't have your back. I will defend you. I don't care if you're wrong. You'll always be right with me. And you'll never have to worry about being wrong or being safe. Because with me, you'll always be safe.
I love you. You are the greatest guy I've ever met. And I don't even know where to begin as to telling you how much you mean to me. You are someone I've always been waiting for. You make me the happiest girl on earth. You care about me. You love me. Every part of me, everything about me, and thank you. I'm so excited to start my life with you. I never imagined this day would come, that I would be lucky enough to have someone like you. You know, there was a point in my life where I got discouraged and I never thought that Prince Charming would come, but then out of the blue, you came. And I know that God provided a way for that. And I know that He knows how much you and I needed each other. I am so excited to see what else is in store for us. I know that this is eternity, and I know that no matter how crazy life gets, or no matter how hard it gets, that if we just trust that one another loves each other, all will be well, and this life will be beautiful, and I know that's going to be with you. I'm excited to dance with you forever. I'm excited to learn from you and ride horses with you, raise a family with you, grow old with you. And I know that sounds cliche and everything, but I am so excited for all of it. Thank you for always supporting me in what I do. Thank you for helping me grow and progress into the person that you see me as, and helping me believe that. When I'm weak, you're strong. If you were gone, I don't know where I'd be. You.
kill me if I didn't have you.
One night to be confused, one night to speed up truth. We had a promise paid for us and then away. Both under influence, we had divine said to know what to say. Mind is a bridge of faith to call for hands of above. A simple touch, one night to push and scream, and then relief. 10 days of perfect tunes, the colors red and blue. We had a promise made, we were in love. To call for hands of above, to lean on.
Trying not to stare the night that I first met you. You had me mesmerized. And 3 weeks later in the front porch light, taking 45 minutes to kiss goodnight, I hadn't told you yet. But I thought I loved you then. And now you're my whole life. Now you're my whole. About you, girl, like a river meets the sea, stronger than it's ever been. We've come so far since that day, and I thought I loved you then. I remember taking you back to right where I first met you. You were so surprised. There were people around, but I didn't care. I got down on one knee right there once again.
And I know that you cherish her and will never change. She is my everything. And I'm so grateful for her. And I'm grateful for you as well. Congratulations.
We watched you really become a man. And we're proud of you. Very proud of you.
Don't get killed and don't sign anything. Just try to reach 30. If you can just reach 30, you're going to be okay. But on his birthday on February 2nd, he said, guess what, Mom? And I said, what? He goes, I'm 30. And I said, fine. And he was like, but today he said, I finally had this realization that everything that's happened to me brought me to this day. But you don't start getting that until you're at least 30, maybe 50. But it's all that butterfly effect stuff. You can't look back at something and say, well, I wish that would have never happened to me, because if it didn't, none of us would be here today, right now. I know that both of these people are very deserving of each other, and I'm really excited that he has this huge Christmas family now. I can't wait to see how this family develops. So, Paul, we can't tell you how happy we are. Thank you to all of Madalyn's family for loving him as much as we do.
There was two guys that were passing through the gate. They were passing on through the heavenly gate. And the guy on the other side of the gate asked, do you know Christ? And he goes, well, yeah, you had something to do with the commandments and the Sermon on the Mount and everything. And he goes, okay, that's fine. Why don't you go ahead and pass? And the other guy came in and he immediately knelt down because he recognized Christ. And he knew who he was. And you guys are that in no class. And I love you guys.
And it's an honor to be your dad.
A dream come true. So I'm standing here with my hand held out, knowing that your love will never fade. I stand amazed without a doubt. I want to hear your voice in the morning when I rise. Think I know I'm just a normal man, only made of sand, except when you're by my side. Will you love me, teach me, don't leave me, I pray. When I'm thinking of the times, your hands in mine, together we'll stay. You made me better today than I was before. Now my heart can rest and I will search no more. You made me better today. My heart is wings. Oh, you take me away. And every prayer I've ever prayed was answered today. So I'm standing here with my hand held out, knowing that your love will never leave. My heart's on my sleeve, and now I believe. I wanna hear your voice in the morning when I rise. I think I know I'm just a normal man, only made of sand, except when you're by my side. Will you love me, teach me, don't leave me, I pray. When I'm thinking of the times, your hands in mine, together we'll stay. You made me better today than I was before. And now my heart can rest and I will search no more. You made me. made me better.
Today.
What is this?
I don't want to look.
Don't see it.
Did you get it?
Yeah.